Hello, today we're going to construct the circumcenter of a triangle using the geometry app in the fx-CG500 CAS graphing calculator. I have the graphing calculator in front of me. This is what it looks like if you have the handheld. It's got a very large screen in the center where we have our menus. And since it has a touch screen, you can toggle with the stylus or your finger and look at all the menu items here. I'm using the emulator, so I am going to change the view of this to the resizable one because then I have a lot more screen, but I did want to start off in what the students would see. So when we go into the geometry app, this is their workspace and they can use it as they see fit and they use all of their tools up here. This is a full geometry software, so it has, you know, all the constructions and objects that you want to be able to do in a typical geometry software. So it's all here in this calculator. When working in the emulator, I don't have to stay in this small screen like I would with my students. So it sort of depends what you want to do. If you want to be showing the buttons exactly what the students see, stay this way, but you can also right click and go to the resizable mode, which then gives you a much larger workspace, which is really nice if you're working distance learning or showing this up at the front of the classroom. So you have a bigger space when you can add more things. So I'm gonna work in the big space right now. We can toggle back at the end. So I wanna construct the circumcenter of a triangle, which is the intersection of the perpendicular bisectors of the three sides. So first I want to get my triangle in there. I want it to be a general triangle so that it, whatever I find out, the properties, the conjectures I make, apply to all triangles. And so if I make a general triangle, I can then make it be any specific triangle, but it works for all triangles. So to do that, a couple different ways you could. You could get the segment tool. So notice my tools are up here. I can either use the pictures. So if I use this, you notice everything is kind of picture oriented, or I can use the draw menu that has all of the things out written out. So if I wanted to, you know, pick a triangle this way, I could do that. So I could do it with segments. I'm going to do the cheating way because I want to save time here. And so this is kind of drawing specific shapes in one step. And it's a tool. So these are a triangle, general triangle tool, isosceles triangle tool, equilateral triangle tool, quadrilateral tool. So if I choose this tool, it means I'm going to be able to make a triangle in one step. So notice it is an incredibly large triangle. And if you were in the student mode, let's just show you what it looks like on the student mode. So fixed size is what the calculator looks like. So it's still a pretty large triangle. It takes up a majority of the space. You can dynamically change that by selecting any vertex, since this is a general triangle. And once it's selected, then move it and you can make it be whatever triangle you want. So this almost looks like a right triangle now. Not quite, but almost, which is what you want. You want to be able to change it to infinitely many examples of any triangle and show that those properties we're coming up with are consistent. So I'm going to toggle back to the resizable mode just because it's a lot more space for me to work with. So here's my triangle again. Notice it doesn't really fit in my screen. So I'm going to go up to my view and zoom it to fit into the screen I'm working in. So there is my triangle at this point. I now want to construct the perpendicular bisector of each side. So there is a tool that can do that. I'm going to select a side. So you know it's selected because it highlights, it gets these little squares in it to show you it's highlighted. And I'm going to go to the draw menu and construct as one way to do it. So notice I have a perpendicular or a perpendicular bisector. I want the perpendicular bisector. So that not only finds the midpoint, but also then a perpendicular at that midpoint. So it's two things in one, basically. So there is the perpendicular bisector of this side. And now we can go do the same to all the other sides. Now notice all my lines and stuff are the same. You can at any point change the color of an object, any object on here. So I'm going to just show you how to do that with this one. That's under edit and it's the style. And let's say I want to change the line color. Let's make these lines red. Okay. I could also change the style of the line if I wanted, make it thicker, but we're just going to leave it where it is right now. I just wanted to show you that you could do that. So now I have this red line kind of so I can see my perpendicular bisector a little better. So let's do the next one. So again, you select your side, you go up to your tool. Notice the tool, the picture of the perpendicular bisector is now showing up because it's the last tool I use. So all I have to do is click it and it will make the perpendicular bisector here. And let's do the third side. And so now I have all three bisectors on here. And again, I could change the color, but I'm not going to do that for this just for time's sake. But notice that my perpendicular bisectors are all intersecting. They're concurrent. So this point of intersection is what we call the circumcenter. So I could actually highlight it, actually bring that point up. So I'm going to select at least two of them and go to my tool, and you'll see the picture that looks like an intersection. I'm going to choose that, and it puts an intersection point there. I think I will make this one larger. So again, to select first, then go to edit and style, and you can change the size, the color, all those types of things. So I want to change the size of this to be a little thicker so that it stands out. And maybe let's even change the color of this to green so that it really stands out. So now you'll see, I'm going to click off in a white space. This is now my circumcenter. And so what you want to do once you have students construct it is have them measure things. So are there any special properties, or what do I notice happens to the circumcenter as I move the triangle? So let's make the triangle smaller. And notice my circumcenter has moved outside of the triangle. So unlike a couple of the other points of concurrency, this one can change location. It doesn't always stay inside the triangle. So let's see if we can make it be, ooh, it's almost on the triangle. So what kind of triangle would make my circumcenter be right on it? And oh, it looks like a 90, and I could verify and measure. So there's lots of things you could do. Measure the angles, measure the distance. Is there anything that's interesting about these? That's what we want students to discover. And as they discover something, they can write it down. So the nice thing about this calculator handheld is that you can also include text on here. So I'm going to do that by going to draw, and there's a text tool, and it allows me to say the circumcenter changes location. So it's on the triangle if it's right. And again, we can have a lot more discussion, but I'm just showing you that you can add text. And so you end up with this nice document where they might have angle measures. They might have, you know, so you could measure this angle. We could maybe see if it is actually a right triangle. It looks like a right triangle. Oh, I have more than one thing selected. So let's try that again. And here's where it's nice that you have a generic. So it's almost 90. So I was pretty close. So we could be, it's probably pretty hard, but the idea is a right triangle going to have its circumcenter on the triangle on that side, on that hypotenuse, if you think about it, right? So that's what we're exploring here. You've constructed it, and now they're going to measure and verify and come up with all the different props that the circumcenter is equidistance to each of the vertices. So if I were to measure the distance from D to B, let's try that. Let's measure the difference, the distance. So we're going to measure the distance there. And let's measure the distance to C. And I'm just going to use that same tool. Oh, notice they're being the same. So these are the things you're hoping they discover because they've made the construction, and now they're going to be testing out different measures, angles, where locations of the circumcenter are, those types of things. So if I measure this, you'll notice that it seems to be true right now that all the distance from that circumcenter to any vertex seems to be the same. Well, what if I change the triangle? And here's where that dynamic ability of dynamic geometry comes in. I can make a different triangle very quickly. And all of them are different, all the ones I've done, but notice, even though the distance changed, the fact that they were all the same distance remained constant. So these are things that they can test.